time is 15 minutes later.
Yeah.
This is all for me. I have the, this presentation. This project is in northeast of China. This is the tallest building in northeast. The project is in the Shenyang. The total building area is 1.07 million square meters. And the building height is 5. For the T1, for this one, it's 565 meters high. This is the total plan. The T2 is 330 meters high. This is the T1 is 565. Above the ground, we designed the seismic joint. The total, this is five buildings as a residence, it's 220 meters high. So total, including the podium and commercial, is 1.07 billion square meters. This is the 113 stories of the T1 tower, and about 356,000 square meters building area. This is a structural system shoot, and we can see that the height, the build, the structure height and width ratio is about 10, and the core ratio is about 70.4. This is the core size is very important issues in, related to the efficiency of the building. If they're too large, efficiency will be low. Okay. The structure system provide enough redundancy and multiple system, and as a matter, raised frame exterior has the inside core, and between inside core and exterior structure is optimal. And that batch class, this is a together, work together. The main column use the concrete field, inside concrete field, steel tube. And inside the core is used as concrete, and put some section steel in the core. The total structure is 8 columns around the side. And the next column is, before I did the Pingan Tower, the column is like this. For this, Pingan Tower is 660 meters. This is 565. But the building area is very similar. This time we changed the column, rotated 90 degrees. We find that this is better than this one. Reason is because the column's center line is larger than this. And that means increase the whole structure's thickness. And at the meantime, because it's rotated along the exterior structures, the stature and stiffness will be increased. And also for the torsion is good. The main columns is used like this. Later I will talk about the transmission beam is very important for this kind of component. the core is the plan like this. This is a long story, this is up story. It's changed the thickness and the corner is above that. We change the core as a column. We increase the building area its efficiency. And also have the structure work. In the bottom, we try to keep the stiffness and also reduce the thickness of the wall. We use some steel plate inside in the lower 12 stories. This is the, you can see the cores and columns. And above the tower is we use this instead of the core, you use the raised steel structure because of the earthquake. We by the dynamic analysis find that this is very very efficient and useful for the very capacity and ductility. The outrigger is four outriggers along the vertical directions. And the outrigger is the important issue is outrigger's anchor area. Outrigger's anchor area, the core shear wall, the shear in the shear wall is changed dramatically. We have to be very careful to strengthen the shear wall in the anchor end. And the bell truss is the very important issues for the whole structure stiffness and spatial. And we use the, under the lower zone, we use the double truss. And up zone use the single truss. And all this, and the bracing is inside. All this truss and bracing is to the column. Is symmetrical and help the columns work and make the structure work. And the bracing is in the lower stories, but open, we use the chevron. And above that is used the single. Later I will talk about the bracing and bracing's horizontal restraint for avoid ducking. This is all these bracing. And the top structure I just already talked about. We change to the steel braced structure like this. And outside, the eight columns go up. This is for the facade and curtain walls. And the gravity system, we use this double for the, in the low stories, we use the double beam. And the spring system like this. This is a large span, this is 27 meters. We take out the gravity, small columns. We use no any columns and the structure members between two columns. This is kind of providing a back burst vision for the on inside. And another issue is help construction. Avoid the congestion the gravity columns with all these beams. And at the same time, this is especially for the comfortability, is very good. If we did the single beam, we find the acceleration is a little more high than the standards. And if we put the double beams, they can work together. This is for the comfortability, is good. The slab is just a normal, you know, we use this, in China now, we like to use this composite slab. This slab is the, and two ways work, not like provide deck. And provide deck is we use to maybe only in here. This area is used as two ways. This project, we have the some key technologies. First, the key technology is about the how to realize the concrete field steel cube column. The steel and inside concrete work together, because normally all these loads is comes from gravity load and wind load or earthquake load. From connection is the beam connected with the steel. How to transfer all these loads from the steel to inside the concrete? We find the additional transmission beams very important. And by the test in Baoneng University, and we this is for these kinds of columns. It's very important technique, technology. And when the steel deformation, the beam will work, force the inside concrete work with the steel. Especially for these kinds of large size large size column is very important issue. Second issue is about the factory. This is a Chinese code, and also we check the US code is the same. It's used this one. This means the width and the thickness ratio. This is based from the avoid the plate local buckling first before yield. So for the steel collar, for the steel plate effectively, we should limit the ratio. By this ratio, is the reading is like this. These areas maybe is when this reach the buckling, the back is maybe less than the yield stress. So this the plate, the steel plate, maybe not so safe, or the efficiency cannot provide. So this is a very important issue. But this is comes from this we can from the buckling analysis, we can put these here this code limit. But for our these columns, normally if we follow this one, will be if we follow this one, the thickness of the plate will be high. The steel ratio will be reached to, normally will reach the 8 to 10%, because it depends on the FY, is the steel yield strength. This is so this is maybe not so efficient and economic. In this product, we proposed this kind of stiffener. This is very different from the normal stiffener. Normal stiffener is like this. This stiffener we call it a T-stiffener. It's a very good, because T-stiffener, the stiffness, if you, if the same steel is much more high than this one, maybe 3 times. And the T-stiffener, another issue is, can push inside the concrete work together. When the steel plate buckling outside, the wood, the concrete, inside the concrete will work together with the teeth stiffen. So based on that, we got the, we find if we put the stiffener work together with the plate, the stiffness stiffness comparison with the plate stiffness, the ratio we call is the gamma. EI is the stiffness of the T section in Korean concrete. And the DB is the plate stiffness. This ratio is very, very important. If the ratio of the width of the thickness ratio large, this stiffness can will be large. If follow the code, the stiffness is zero. That means don't need a stiffener. So this is very efficient. This is in our project. We use this technology. The ratio is width and thickness ratio reach to 100 over 60, 65 to 100. And put the T section stiffener. And the gamma is over the theoretical value. And also the steel can save about 5,000 tons only in this project for these columns. So this is the idea is we fix from the code and derive got this formula. Now it's a test. Another issue is about the hinge level method. For tall building, all these vertical members under the gravity load, the compression stress will be different. And the compression deformation will be different. The result like this, 2-3. If the column the foundation is larger, this cup, the floor will be not level. And if the whole structure like I did the Doha Tower is some columns take the more loads, some columns swallows, but column size is the same, the building will be inclined. And another issue is if the difference between vertical elements too large and the gravity load, additional force will be very large. This is not so safe and not so economical, especially combined with the earthquake load and wind load. Sometimes it will be not so safe for the structure. So we proposed, we call it a hinge leveling method. This is a method is just only for the calculate. At the beginning, we hinge all these horizontal members connected with the vertical members. If some bracing is just a take out and put all these gravity loads under the whole structure, then check the vertical elements deformation. Of course, at the time, some difference will between the vertical elements. Then we can adjust the vertical members cross sections or change of the layouts of the structure, the structure plan. Then try to minimize the difference. Then fix all these members, horizontal members with the vertical members. Then do the whole design and calculation. This method only for the adjust and check vertical members to avoid too large vertical deformation difference. And in our project, we did that. We found only change a little, like the core exterior wall and interior wall thickness, not so large, maybe 100, 200 like that. That can reduce the difference between core and column. The core wall and wall, the difference also, difference is large, and the cover beams, then force will be large. Bending moment and the shear force will be large. So reduce that, then we can find all these covering beams and the shear force will be reduced a lot. This product is only not so big change, but can reduce all the member force around 50%. Another issue, number four is a bucking analysis. All this, because this bracing is across 12 stories or 13 stories, the length is about 80 meters. The bucking is, we should be very careful, especially under the earthquake and wind load. We should check the bucking and use this belt load plus wind load as a little case check the bucking. And we find if no any connection between the brace with the floor slab, the bucking will be very serious. The minimum bucking coefficient will be much more lower. Then if we connect the bracing with the floor slab, this is every story connect. And we then calculate, we find it's of course is great. And the bucking, the brace with the, all this slab, through this connection, not take the gravity load, but provide the horizontal restraint, will be very good for the bracing bearing capacity, avoid the bucking. And this is the detail. We use the horizontal plate connected with this bucking. In the construction drawings, we take every story because this is a bracing and all is concrete. By this connect for construction is also easy, and for the brace is the same. Another issue is construction measure. For tall building, one thing is we try to let the gravity load go directly, especially like earthquake and the bracing, because this is times members is between the story to story, and especially like bracing is across 12 stories. If we not take a special measure, some gravity loads in construction stage will go through the bracing, will go through some part, will go through the bracing or the weather of the alternators. This is not so good because these kinds of members, especially is used for the horizontal load, earthquake and wind load. And it takes some gravity load. One thing is not safe, another thing is not economical. So we take the measure is during the construction, use this use the boat with the sufficient clearance as release all these web port and wires connect with the column and the core. Then, after main structure finish, then connect. For the bracing is also same. The bracing the top we use as tolerance bolts connect to avoid the gravity loads go through the brace during the construction. Then, of course, if you take this kind of construction measure, should we check the structural safety during the construction? Because at that time, the stiffness of the whole structure is reduced. Then we check this stiffness, check this 10 years repair, return clearance, wing load, the storage drifts, and the bearing capacity. It is, that is okay. Then we take this construction measure. And then the last one is about the deformation analysis. Because this is you use some concrete structure as a core and column inside, okay? The column, the concrete shrinkage and creep is for this deformation is a great effect, great effect. So we take this analyze, carry, we use the whole construction simulation and also consider the concrete creep and shrinkage, and also take into account of the steel ratio influence. From the first day of construction until 50 years, we find this is we take the because this is a structure is of almost symmetrical. We take these 2 points, check. We find that the between the core and the column still has some deformation difference. Although we already adjusted, but still have some, not eliminated. And do this one, we can keep this. Why we do this is do one thing. One thing is we try to, we can keep the story height by this compensation. Because every story during the construction already shut by compression. We can compensation and keep the story height no change. And at the same time, core and the column, we take a different height compensation, can keep the force level and horizontally. And at the same time, we should reserve the vertical member's length. If we check the compensation of the story height, especially for the steel column and steel section steel, we should reserve the length. Average is we just already take the calculation is 2 or 3 millimeters for every stone. And some stone is high and maybe high. This total figure is what coordinate with this. So, this project, we used all this time technology. And building safety should be is okay. And the total amount of the steel is 175 kilograms per square meter. Thank you.
What kind of foundation system do you have?
Foundation in Shenyang area is very good. And we, for T1, we use the pipe. And the other is just a flat. And we calculate the settlement within 10 millimeters. Within about 7 or 5 millimeters. Very small.
So in the slide, one slide. One of the slides you show that to check the drift for the wing load is 1 over 500.
This is for the construction stage.
For construction stage. How about the final? Is there any criteria?
The final is about under the wing load, 1 over 800.
Yeah.
This is for the earthquake.
Yes, earthquake. Because the U.S. said that we have a drift limit for earthquake, but we don't have a drip limit specified for wind. I did ask that question several times.
In China, we use the earthquake. It's three levels.
Okay.
In the United States, two levels. We use this, we call it minimum, and the medium, and the maximum. This product, we did the medium should be followed the Chinese code. And for the maximum, we do the elasto and the plasto dynamic analysis. Check the, all these drifts and damage and plastic screen.
Professor Fu, you showed in an early slide that you corrected. Or you made some correction to your design by pinning the horizontal members to determine how much it, how much movement you had, so that you could relieve some forces in the beam in the column by computing. Did that do the differential movement between the columns and the core? You put a pin and you found out how much to adjust. Did you do that after the differential settlement, or did you do that just due to elastic analysis?
This is for the adjusting method, it's only for the elastic condition. This is for the vertical members design we use. For the long term, is we already did here, is still have some difference between, because this minimized cannot eliminate all the difference. If not do that, the difference will be larger. This is very beneficial for the economic, or especially for the tall building. And we did the elasto and the plasto analysis, dynamic analysis for the under the maximum perspective, and the behavior is okay. We is also used the base performance design philosophy. Same as United States. Learn from United States.
Mm-hmm. Thank you for your presentation. It's very impressive. I want to ask a question about the tower redundancy. So because I think for this kind of height of tower, it's very important for the redundancy design. Also, how do you deal with progressive collapse design for this tower? Do you do any...
You talk about progress.
progressive collapse. Yeah.
Okay. Progressive design. This time we didn't do that. Before we did something is suppose one column is collapsed or something like that. This time we didn't. But I think for this only 8 columns, maybe one column is okay, 2 columns is not okay. Now this is my concept. Before we did that, yeah. Is right? Yeah. But we didn't do that this time, okay?
But I don't think US do that too.
Yeah, we did some project in the Middle East. They asked us, and the client asked us check if a pair of columns by the exposure, then check the structure safety and what kind of measure, if necessary, keep the building not to collapse.
One way of wondering, seems like your composite columns, you have to do the rebar casing first and then you weld the rebar. Is that not going to do?
No,
you weld the plate.
Yeah, the plate is welded in the factory, fabricated in the factory, and on the site, only weld along the maybe 2 stories, one columns, okay? Then column by column, weld on the site, 2 stories weld. And other members, like the beam, truss, or is bolt first, then weld.
Yeah, I want to ask a question regarding the various innovative uses of your approach for building this particular building. Do you foresee these innovative approaches that you're using to build this particular building to become more common in use in the future for future tall buildings? Well, like for example, the T braces and the braces that are going up using various plates. I mean, you foresee this becoming more common in the future for
this is a very new technology in China, and but I think not only for China, I think for the United States we also try to use that. And we will do further test to prove, but in this project we wanted to use. Okay, thank you.